Good evening, I'm John Yang. Tensions ratcheted up today along the border between Lebanon and Israel. Three UN military observers and a Lebanese interpreter were wounded in an explosion. They were patrolling the Lebanese side of the border as part of their peacekeeping mission. A UN spokesperson says they're investigating the source of the explosion and that the observer's vehicle was clearly marked and that all parties had been told about the patrol. Israel's military denied any involvement. Israeli troops and Hezbollah fighters have been trading attacks across that border for weeks. Meanwhile, a convoy of three ships carrying 400 tons of food and other aid set sail for Gaza from Cyprus today. The UN has warned of imminent famine in Gaza. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelenskyy fired more of his top aides in his ongoing government reshuffle. It comes as Russia launched more drone and missile attacks on eastern Ukraine overnight, killing two people in Donetsk. Over the last 24 hours, there's been a barrage of strikes from Russia, many targeting energy infrastructure. Ukraine has put planned power outages in place for about 120,000 people in the region. In Peru, government agents raided the home of President Dina Boluarte as part of an investigation into a collection of luxury watches and whether they had been disclosed. Last night, a team used a battering ram to break down a door as they sought multiple Rolex timepieces. Boluarte has been president for a little more than a year, and she said she's owned at least one Rolex watch that she bought with her own money when she was 18 years old. Today, Boluarte defended herself, saying she's an honest woman with clean hands. And in Rome, Pope Francis presided over an Easter Vigil service at St. Peter's Basilica. He missed last night's Good Friday procession as a health precaution. The 87-year-old pontiff has limited his public appearances lately, even skipping his Palm Sunday homily. He's been struggling with respiratory problems. Still to come on PBS News Weekend, the role of the nation's largest health insurance program in America's safety net, and the hidden history of a black nurse who served her country in a variety of ways.
This is PBS News Weekend from WETA Studios in Washington, home of the PBS NewsHour, weeknights on PBS.